Washington football saw a lot of success with Chris Peterson at the helm as he brought them to the college football playoff, multiple Rose Bowls, and they won so many games while he was there. Washington football was honestly one of the top brands in the country at the time, but unfortunately, they are starting to fall off a little bit. I was pretty worried when Washington hired Jimmy Lake to be their next head coach, and it seems to be backfiring for both the program, the fan base, and the players now. As of yesterday, there was a report that Lake will not be the head coach after this year, and in today's video, I want to quickly talk about who Jimmy Lake is, what has gone wrong for him so far, the state of Washington football, and what I think is going to happen next. But before we get into it, nearly 80% of you guys aren't subscribed, so be sure to quickly do that, smash that like button for the algorithm, and turn on post notifications so you never miss when I upload. Now, let's talk about Jimmy Lake and Washington football. So as I said, Chris Peterson did a great job when he was hired in 2014. In Peterson's first year, the team went 8-6, then in 2015, they went 7-6. 2016 is when Washington football really started to take off. They went 12-2, where they ended up going to the college football playoff. In 2017, they went 10-3 and lost in the Fiesta Bowl, and then in 2018, they went 10-4 and lost in the Rose Bowl. At this point, Peterson had a great career at both Boise and Washington, and after an 8-5 campaign in 2019, he decided to hang up the clipboard and retire, which he did deserve. So, who was Washington going to hire next? Well, it was a guy by the name of Jimmy Lake. Lake played for Eastern Washington back in the day, and that is where he got his coaching start. In 2004, he actually coached defensive backs for the Huskies, and then in 2007, he went to the NFL, where he spent time with the Buccaneers and the Lions. In 2012, he joined Chris Peterson's staff at Boise State, and then came over with him in 2014 at Washington. From there, he coached defensive backs and was a defensive coordinator until 2019. In 2020, he was the player's coach. He was seen as a Peterson disciple and someone who could take over for the Washington program. Because of that, they decided to make him the full-time head coach, and there was a lot of excitement around Washington football. Despite a good amount of hype in 2020, Washington struggled. They didn't really get good quarterback play, as Dylan Morris had 4 touchdowns compared to 3 picks, the running game was pretty much non-existent, and the tight end was the leading receiver. That pretty much says all you need to know, but at the same time, Washington barely played. Their games against Cal, Washington State, Oregon, and USC all got scrapped, and they did win 3 of their 4 matchups, including wins over Oregon State, Arizona, and Utah. Their only loss came to Stanford. Technically, they qualified for the Pac-12 championship, but they were unable to play. 3-1 wasn't a bad first year for Lake, but in 2020, expectations were through the roof. Led by Dylan Morris and incoming 5-star freshman Sam Heward, the Huskies began the year ranked number 20. What did they do? They lost at home to Montana by only putting up 7 points. In week 2, they had a chance to right in the ship, but they got embarrassed on national television against Michigan. From there, they beat Arkansas State, barely beat Cal in overtime, and then lost to both Oregon State and UCLA to start out at 2-4, and they easily could have been 1-5. They did beat Arizona and Stanford, but that's not much of an achievement. This past weekend, they played Oregon pretty tough, but this was the epitome of Jimmy Lake's downfall. He had a skirmish with a player on the sideline after he made a mistake, and this went viral, and he was suspended a game because of that. More importantly, though, he had one of the dumbest things I've ever seen a coach do. Down 8 with just over a minute to play, he decided to punt the ball. Washington fans and people watching the game could not believe what they had just witnessed, as why the heck were they going to punt the ball when they were down 1 possession? It just didn't make any sense, but karma had a way of getting back at him. In one of the funniest moments I've ever seen in college football, the long snap threw the ball right over the punter's head, and it hit a cameraman in the stand. This was a safety, and Washington lost by 10 points in heartbreaking fashion. The team is now below 500, but they will still have a chance to get to a bowl game if they can beat Arizona State, Colorado, or Washington State. At this point, I don't know if it's going to happen, but Jimmy Lake has bigger fish to fry. A couple days ago, I saw a report that he would not make it after 2021, so what's going on there? After the altercation with the player, he has been suspended for 1 game, but when you type in Jimmy Lake's name, the first thing that will come up is the fact that it's a matter of when, not if, he will get fired. Lake has seemingly lost control of his emotions, he has lost fan support very quickly, he's not recruiting at a very good level as a lot of guys decommitted, the team isn't performing well, and overall, it seems like everything's on a downward spiral for him. There's not a whole lot of backing to any of these rumors, but if I had to make a guess, I would say that Lake is not going to survive the 2021 season. I never thought he was truly a great hire or someone who could lead a program, and more so, I thought of him as a guy who got promoted to stabilize the program, and maybe he would pan out. Nope, he has not shown that kind of flash or progress, and I think he's going to get canned after this year. Him shoving a player, deciding to punt it on fourth down, down one possession, and him losing a bunch of recruits is going to be the nail in the coffin for him. And unfortunately for Jimmy Lake, his time is limited up north. What do you guys think though? If you're a Washington fan, what do you think of Jimmy Lake? What is the state of the program, and what do you want to do moving forwards? Be sure to let me know down in the comment section. Smash that like button if you want to support today's video. Give me a topic I could do next, and check out all my other videos on the end screen. I hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.